Schools have been encouraged to guide learners in the use of technology.
We shared with parents this morning that technology is with us here today and to stay, and because we have to embrace and find means of living with the new technology, parents need to understand how best they can help their children navigate smoothly through the digital era without losing them to technology and the parenting becoming meaningless because parents cannot connect with their children.
First thing is we must teach our children in sieving out what makes good sense out of the information that is obtained. Because information will keep coming, but enabling the child to know that whatever is going to make sense is this. Therefore, the requirement of the teacher and the parent to explain why. If a child, for example, says, I'm going to do this, if you tell them, don't do this, we must explain why the child cannot do that.
Parents and teachers were also tasked to always monitor and guide their children on internet and gadget use, both at school and home.
The children want to live like Americans while they live in Uganda because it's the Americans that have created content for the children on the social media that they are watching. The children have looked for role models on this technology, some of whom may not really be positive people that we would recommend our children to follow. And these are the most prominent influencers for the society. Sometimes this leading to school dropout as children want to figure out they can also be musicians. The stories that they get from the internet gives them false hope that you can make a breakthrough even when you don't work so hard. And these are some of the negative effects of technology unmatched.
However, teachers highlighted the need for refresher courses to fit into the changing dynamics.
We have allowed these gadgets to be brought, but we have people who are in charge. When you come with a gadget, you submit it to a particular person. You don't get with it for full time. And then it is only used at the time you are going to use it for research under supervision of the teacher. But we have also taken trouble to control our internet provision.
Government has also been urged to equip learners in rural areas with internet gadgets.
I can appeal to government and all the stakeholders to make sure that the other child, we refer to them as the other child in the rural area, the disadvantaged child, even the children in the city from the urban settings that have these ghetto areas where poor people live, such children have no access to the internet that we are talking about, the gadgets we are talking about. But these children are supposed to compete with the same other children in the urban areas. So there must be an effort to reach out to these children. There must be some basic introduction of some of these ICT facilities, more especially in schools, so that these children can compete favorably with the other children in the other parts of the world.
Report compiled by Ismail Subuga for the news.